In packet switching, the information for forwarding traffic is contained in the destination address of every datagram or packet. Similar to how you would write a letter and specify the destination to where you want the letter sent, and that letter might wend its way through multiple intermediate post offices en route to the recipient, packet switching works much the same way. There is no state established ahead of time, and there are very few assumptions made about the level of service that the network provides. This assumption about the level of service that the network provides is sometimes called best effort. So how does packet switching enable sharing? Just as if you were sending a letter, many senders can send over the same network at the same time, effectively sharing the resources in the network. A similar phenomenon occurs in packet switching when multiple senders send network traffic or packets over the same set of shared network links. Now, this is in contrast to the phone network, where if you were to make a phone call, the resources for the path between you and the recipient are dedicated and are allocated until the phone call ends. The mode of switching that the conventional phone network uses is called circuit switching, where a signaling protocol sets up the entire path out of band. So this notion of packet switching and statistical multiplexing, allowing multiple users to share a resource at the same time, was really revolutionary, and it is one of the underlying design principles of the internet that has persisted. Now, an advantage of statistical multiplexing of the links in the network means that a sender never gets a busy signal. The drawbacks include things like variable delay and the potential for loss or dropped packets. In contrast, circuit switching provides resource control, better accounting and reservation of resources, and the ability to pin paths between a sender and receiver. Packet switching provides the ability to share resources and potentially better resilience properties.